deserve all the praise, Lord. You deserve all the glory. We thank you, Jesus, for there's none like you in all the earth. Amen. We are thankful to be in the house of the Lord this afternoon. Amen. With God's precious people. Amen. Just remember, at the end of this month, we have a thing that we're doing called Cover Me Until I Recover. And we're trying to gather some blankets and coats, amen, to take down to John 3:16 on October 29th and hand them out to the homeless people, those that are less fortunate. So if you have some old blankets laying around the house or some old coats that you don't wear anymore, amen, save them for that date, October 29th, amen, because we're going to try to go down and we're going to be a blessing to people that may not have a coat, that may not have a blanket to get under, amen, when the weather turns for the cold, amen. And also, don't forget about this time next month, we're having our Growing Your Marriage God's Way. Amen, Growing Your Marriage God's Way. We've been having it for the last several years, and we guarantee you will be blessed richly if you make the sacrifice and attend. Amen. That's for all married couples. Amen. All those, praise God, who desire to come. Amen. Please get with Elder Yvette Christian. Amen. She has all the details on what you have to do. Amen. If you want to attend. But this morning, if you could turn your Bibles to the book of Deuteronomy, chapter number 8. Amen. Deuteronomy, chapter number 8. Let's continue to keep each other lifted up in prayer. Amen. Let's continually pray for the harvest. Amen. For the harvest here in Tulsa. For the harvest is truly ripe. Amen. And we believe in God for souls. We believe in God for the increase. We believe in God for this place to be full. Amen. They come in. We don't have room enough to receive them. Amen. My God, I hear a stampede coming this way. Amen. Hear a stampede of souls. Amen. Look, we're in the last days. Amen. The government's going to fail people. Amen. The medical system is going to fail. The financial system is going to fail. Family members are going to fail. But one thing, one person that will not, and that is God. People are going to search after God. Amen. And they don't want to be patty cake on the back and with a lukewarm word, but they want truth. Amen. Because prosperity, that sermon's over. Amen. You know, having your name in neon lights and enjoying the pleasures of this world, that sermon's over. Amen. People know that God is still calling them to a higher level, and they will never be satisfied until they get to that place in God. So we know, amen, that God has sent us to this city for such a time as this. But to the book of Deuteronomy, chapter number 8, I'm not going to be before you long this afternoon, but God did give me a word. Amen. Verse number 1 says, all the commandments which I command thee this day shall ye observe to do, that ye may what? That ye may live and multiply and go in and possess the land which the Lord sware unto your fathers. And thou shalt remember all the way which the Lord thy God led thee these 40 years in the wilderness, to humble thee and to prove thee, to know what is in thine heart, whether thou wouldest keep his commandments or no. And he humbled thee and suffered thee to hunger, and fed thee with manna which thou knowest not, neither did thy father know, that he might make thee known. Here we go right here. That man doeth not live by bread alone, but by every word that proceedeth out of the mouth of the Lord do man live. Amen. So what's key there is this, is the latter part of verse number 3. That man do not live by bread alone, but by every word that proceedeth out of the mouth of the Lord. Let us go to the book of Hebrews, chapter number 4, verse number 12. Hebrews 4 and 12. Amen. I thank God for the Logos. Amen. The Logos is the Word. The Logos. I thank God for the Logos. It is the Word of God. Hebrews chapter 4, verse number 12 says, "For the Word of God is quick and powerful and sharper than any two-edged sword, piercing even to the dividing asunder of soul and spirit, and of the joints and marrows, and is a discerner of the thoughts and intents of the heart." Amen. What's key there is verse number 12 in the beginning, where it says, "For the word of God is quick and it is powerful." Amen. We have one more verse, and that's the book of St. John, chapter number 1. Thank you, Jesus. Amen. Thank you, Lord. St. John chapter number 1, beginning in verse number 1, it says, "In the beginning was the Word. In the beginning was the Word. And the Word was with God. And the Word was what? It was God." The Word was God. "The same was in the beginning with God. All things," it says, "all things were made by Him. And without Him was not anything made that was made." Verse 4, "In Him was life. In Him was life, and the life was the light of men." Heavenly Father, we thank you once again for your goodness, your mercy, your love. We thank you for the Spirit of the Lord that is in this place. Lord, this is no ordinary service, God. Anytime we come into your house, God, we come with the spirit of expectation, God. We expected you to move, God. We expected, God, Lord, to pick up, God, amen, our fragments, God, that you want to give us today, the manna from heaven, God. We expect to get our healings today. We expect to be delivered today. We expect to be encouraged, oh God. Lord, this is no ordinary service, God. Where the word of God is going forward, God, it shall not return void, God. Have your way today and use me, God, as a man of God to bring forth your word. We come against every spirit that is not like you, God. Every confusing spirit, every distracting spirit, God, and every spirit is trying to hinder for what the word is going to do today. And we thank you, Lord. In your name we pray. In Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. I am convinced that the word of God is the source of all life. Amen. How many people believe that? That the word of God is the source of all life. Amen. Why? Because the Bible says that. Amen. The Bible says in Genesis chapter number 1, it says, "In the beginning, God created the heaven and the earth. And the earth was without form, the earth was without void, and darkness was upon the face of the deep, and the Spirit of God moved upon the face of the waters." And verse 2 says, "And God said," and God said, God said, "Let there be light," and there was light. In verse 6, God said, "Let there be a firmament in the midst of the waters, and let it divide the waters from the waters." Verse 9 says, "And God said, let the waters under the heaven be gathered together unto one place, and let dry land appear." Verse 11 says, "God said, let the earth bring forth grass, the herb yielding seed, and the fruit yielding after his kind." Verse 14 says, "God said, let there be light in the firmament of the heaven to give light upon the earth." Verse 20 says, "God said, let the waters bring forth abundantly the moving creatures that have life." Verse 24 says, "God said, let the earth bring forth the living creature after his kind, cattle and creeping things." Verse number 26, "God said, let us make man in our own image, after our own likeness, and let him have dominion." So I am convinced that the source of all life is the spoken word of God. It is not Darwin's theory. It is not a Big Bang theory, but it's God's word. When God's word went forward, when God spake, amen, in Genesis chapter 1, things began to come alive. The word of God brings life. The word of God brings life. When God spoke the word, things began to happen. Some people tell you that, amen, that the word of God is wrote by man, and man put it to paper, and man created it in their own mind. But the word of God tells me that it is breathed upon by God. It is inspired by God. The word came directly from him. That's why John said in the beginning, the word was with God, and the word was God. We got to understand, hallelujah, amen, that God wants to give us life, and he's going to give us life through his word. And when you neglect the word, when you disobey the word, amen, when you turn your back and reject the word of God, baby, you do not have life. You do not have life. When you walk in disobedience, you ain't walking in life. You don't have eternal life. You can't have eternal life, amen, disobeying, rejecting, amen, and neglecting the word of God. Amen. God's word is life. God's word is life. So what is life? Amen. The Webster's Dictionary tells us, amen, that life, amen, is the time period after birth that's before death. Amen. That's what the Webster's Dictionary says life is. It is a little mark that's in between when you was born and when you die. That's what the Webster tells us what life is. But from a spiritual perspective and a biblical perspective, amen, I beg to differ. Life is something different. Amen, because someone that has life has to have the following abilities. Number one, they got to recognize. They got to recognize God's divine purpose for their life. Amen. They got to recognize. How do you recognize? You got to distinguish. You got to be identified. Amen. You got to know that God has called you. You got to know that God is real. You got to know that the word of God is absolute. You got to recognize God. Too many people go through life and they don't even recognize God. They don't even acknowledge God. They don't even know God's name. My God, they don't even know the name of God. Amen. But number one, you've got to distinguish. You've got to know. You've got to identify with God's purpose for your life. Amen. Elder Kendrick, just a little more volume on these floor monitors right here. Number two, you've got to grow in accordance with God's word. You've got to cultivate. You've got to nurture. You've got to let the word of God develop you. Come on. Too many people going through life and they're not applying the word of God to their life. Amen. They're the same as they was when they got saved 15 years ago. They still ain't won a soul. They still ain't laid hands on nobody. They still battling addictions and demons and all these manner of things. Why? Because they have not let the word of God, amen, be cultivated into their life. My God. Number three, amen. If you want to know what life really is, you've got to have the ability to reproduce. You got to be able to reproduce, my God, in accordance with God's commandment. Amen. The Bible says, amen, that you want to know a tree by its fruit. But if the tree ain't got no fruit, it ain't reproducing. And nobody knows what a tree is unless it has fruit. You can't tell what kind of tree it is just by the leaves. You got to look at the fruit. So we got to be able to reproduce in accordance with God's commandment. But everything that God made has a principle of life. If you go back to Genesis, everything that God made, amen, the animals, amen, the birds, the fish in the ocean, the vegetation, they all have a principle of life. But look, that's not the life that the word of God is talking about. Amen, that was all a part of the creation. But that's not the life that he's talking about, amen. God is talking about eternal life. God is talking about eternal life. Eternal life is not a natural life. Eternal life is restricted only to the human beings that Jesus Christ, or should I say God, made in his image. Amen. Because when God breathed upon us the breath of life, we became a living soul. So that's what gave us either eternal life or eternal damnation. Amen. Mankind is not like a dog. It's not like your cat. It's not like your goldfish. We're going to spend eternity somewhere. It's either going to be in heaven or it's going to be in hell. But we have eternal life because the soul that God gave us when he made us. Because he made us in his image. So it's safe to say that eternal life is equivalent to a living soul. It's safe to say that eternal life is equivalent to one's obedience to the word of God. If you want eternal life, you got to be obedient to God's word. It's safe to say, amen, that eternal life is equivalent to Jesus Christ. Why? Because the Bible says in him we have life. In him we have life. So if you want eternal life, baby, you got to know who he is. You got to have a relationship with him. You got to know him. You got to understand where you are in this salvation process. Where you at, amen, in this kingdom of God? Where's your walk with God? What is your purpose? What it is that God wants you to do? Amen. My God. The Bible says, in him we have eternal life. Amen. Who is him? The word of God. Who is him? The word of God. Amen. The word became flesh. The word became flesh. Who is him? The word of God. Amen. Elder priest on Wednesday, amen, the prayer is not enough. Prayer's not going to get us there. Amen. Look, if you ain't got the word of God, you ain't doing nothing. Amen. You can't even pray unless you have the word in you. Come on, somebody. You can't fast. Amen. You can't say no to drugs and alcohol. Amen. You can't say no to the pleasures of this world without the word of God being built up into you. Amen. Because the word is the source. The word is the source. God said, amen, in him we have life. In his word we have life. Amen. The problem in 2016 is people ain't in their word like they used to be. They pray, they fast, they worship, they say hallelujah anyhow, but they're not in the word of God. Because when we get in the word of God, we'll have a change in our life. Because the word of God will change us. It will mold us into the image of God. All the folks ain't getting in the word. Without the word of God operating in one's life, there is no eternal life. If God ain't operating in you, the word of God, amen, ain't leading you, guiding you, convicting you, amen, telling you to preach, telling you to teach, telling you to pray, telling you to fast, if it's not growing in you, you're dying. If the word of God has not grown in you from yesterday, then you are dying. We pray all the time, Lord, increase in me. Amen. Lord, you increase. Let my flesh decrease. Well, what do you think is going to increase in you? It's the word of God. It's the word of God that increases in us. We already got filled with the Holy Ghost. We need the word of God. There is no eternal life outside of the word of God. My God. This world will tell you that partying, going to clubs, drinking, and having all sorts of physical pleasure is living. Amen. Having sex is living. Enjoying, amen, amen, all the benefits of the world is living. That's a lie. It's dying. It's dying. Amen. If you want, amen, to understand what living is, you've got to be righteous. You've got to be righteous. You've got to be full of the word of God. Because the Bible tells us that the unrighteous shall not inherit the kingdom of God. And that was the people that was drinking, partying, clubbing, having sex, amen, enjoying the pleasures of this world. They're not living, they're dying. They do not have righteousness. They do not have eternal life. Amen. I'm convinced the word of God must dwell richly within us. Amen. Why? Because there's too many false words out there. In other words, man, the false prophets, the false teachers, they have came in and they have twisted the word of God. Amen. We have all these new, amen, versions of the Bible. The NIV, the HCSB, and all these different versions. And what they've done, they have taken away from God's word. They have changed the definition, amen, to words that God does not mean, amen. They have changed the meaning of those words. So we must know the word for ourselves, and it's got to dwell richly within us. Amen. You can pray, you can worship, you can witness, you can fast, but without the word of God having preeminence, without it dominating inside of our lives, we are still in darkness. Come on, the word of God is a lamp unto my feet and a light unto my path. Without the word of God, I am lost. Without the word of God, I'm in darkness. We got to understand the importance of the logos of the word of God. Amen. Because just coming to church ain't going to do it. If you're banking on just hearing the word on a Sunday and a Wednesday, and that's all you get all week, you are lost. You are lost. Amen, my God. More of you, Lord, and less of me. The Bible says this is how important the word of God is. Jesus, amen, instructed the devil because he was trying to tempt him. Jesus instructed the devil in Matthew 4:4. He said, man shall not live by bread alone, but by every word that proceedeth out of the mouth of God. That should let us know right there the importance of the word of God. That should let us know, praise God, that we cannot do it without God's word. Amen. The Bible says in John 6:35, Jesus said unto them, I am the bread of life. My God, for he that cometh to me shall never hunger, and he that believeth on me shall never thirst. And if you go down to that same chapter, the verse number 15, the Bible says, this is the bread which cometh down from heaven, that a man may eat thereof and not die. That's that eternal life. We shall eat the word and never die. We shall eat it and never die. He says, I am the living bread which come down from heaven. And if any man eat of this bread, he shall live forever. That is eternal life. Amen. This is the source for eternal life. Amen. John 14:6. Jesus said, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No man cometh unto the Father but by me. Amen. John 1:14. And the word became flesh and dwelt among us. John 11:25. Jesus said unto her, I am the resurrection and the life. He that believeth in me, though he were dead, he shall live forever. Amen. Jesus letting us know he's the source. He's the word manifest in the flesh. And if you want eternal life, you got to get with the word. The Bible says, study to show thyself approved unto God, a workman that needed not be ashamed, but rightly dividing the word of truth. Amen. That's God telling us we got to study. Amen. If we're called to the ministry, if we're an elder, then we got to study. We've got to study. We got to prove ourselves to God. Amen. And we're called into the ministry. I don't care if you're an apostle, a prophet, an evangelist, a pastor, a teacher. If you've got a calling upon your life, you've got to study to show yourself approved unto God. My God. Then the second part of John 1:4, it says, the life was the light of men. So in other words, in him was life, and the life was the light of men. Look, in order for these lights to come on in this sanctuary, there had to be a power source. Somewhere, amen, there's some kind of power transformer or transfer box, transfer station. But somewhere there's electricity coming into this sanctuary that's turning the lights on in here. Right? Now the Bible says that the life was the light of men. So what was the light of men? What lit the light? Amen. The word of God. The word of God is the life. In the beginning was the word. The word was with God, and the word was God. Amen. In him we have life. In who? In the word. In the word we have life. So the conduit that lights up the light that's within us is the word of God. Can it be that too many saints of God are walking in darkness because they have little word or no word? If you got little word, then where's the light? The Bible says the word of God is a light. It is a lamp. But if you have no word and you are little word, amen, then you have no light. Right. Amen. How are people going to come, amen, and be saved if you're in darkness with them? Amen. Look at Eli and his situation. The Bible says in 1 Samuel, Eli was a priest. He was the high priest. He was the only messenger during that time. He was the only messenger during that time. And the Bible says that Eli, amen, that he was old, he was fat, And he went to sleep in the house of God, and the light inside the temple went out. The light inside the temple went out. Why did the light go out? Because Eli was in rebellion with God. Eli was in disobedience with the word of God. Amen. He was letting his sons do all manner of evil, and they were getting away with it, and Eli would not rebuke them. Right. He would not get him in line. So what happened? God had to replace him because he was not the light that he wanted to use. Because Eli's light went out. Amen. We have so many problems today. We focus on the problems. And don't you know, hallelujah, that when you let go of the word and focus on the problem, that your light is going out? Too many people in the house of God are in darkness because they're all wrapped up in their little problems, and they're not focusing on the word of God. And the light of God went out in the temple, and you're wondering why a co-worker ain't saved, a co-worker ain't coming to church, a family member's not delivered. You wonder why you're still dealing with the same old addictions, the same old mind games, because you focus on the mind game and not the word of God. The word of God is the source for the light. If you want the light to come on in your life, amen, you better get back in the word. You better get in the word of God. My God. Thank you, Jesus. Webster defines light as something that makes something visible. Amen. Light is something that makes things visible or affords illumination. That's what light is, according to the Webster's dictionary. Amen, but the Bible dictionary is always different than the Webster's dictionary. When you look up the word light in the Bible dictionary, it says manifestation. Come on now. It says a manifestation of what? Of God. Yes. God is the light. When you get to heaven, it's not going to be no street lights in heaven. When you get to heaven, it's going to be a glow coming from the throne, and that's going to be Jesus Christ sitting on his throne. Come on. My God, in Genesis chapter 1, amen, God said, let there be vegetation, and my God, let it be trees, and all this took place. But then, on the fourth day, he said, let there be sun, moon, and stars. Right. So what was the light on the first 3 days? It was God. God Almighty was the light. So what I'm trying to say is this. Amen. Spiritually, we are the light of the world. We don't set us under a bushel. They don't put us under a candlestick, but they put us on top so we can manifest the power of God. And what's going on, amen, people are on top, but they don't have no light. And people still need deliverance. They still need to be brought out of sin. Chains still need to be broken. They're still in bondage because they don't know. They can't see their way. Come on, that's the church of 2016. They're drinking, they're committing adultery. Amen. They're divorcing and marrying, divorcing and marrying, divorcing and marrying in the house of God. Amen. Their children ain't saved. Amen. The church of 2016, because there is no light. My God. The Bible says that we are a chosen generation, a royal priesthood, a holy nation, that we are peculiar people, that we should show forth the praises of him. That's that manifestation. We are showing forth. We are manifesting the praises of him who called us out of darkness and brought us into his marvelous light.
Yes.
That's why we got to get back to the source. Amen. You can't do nothing without the word of God. Even the Bible says you can't do nothing without me. Who is he talking about? He's talking about Jesus, who is the word manifest in the flesh. Come on, you can do nothing without the source. Amen. Too many people trying to be like Eli. They watered down the word, or they neglected the word. And what's happening, amen, is we got a bunch of religious people that ain't got power enough, amen, to blow their nose. But it's something about the spoken word of God that it will not return void. I'm convinced that all of us have problems. All of us have got something going on in our life. Amen. If you ain't got nothing going on in your life, you need to check yourself. Because something, you may be doing something wrong. Amen. We trouble on every side. Amen. But the Bible says we trouble on every side. Amen. But when you're in trouble, what is your weapon? What is your offensive weapon that you use to fight your way out of the corner? What is your weapon that you use, amen, to back the devil up off your children? Amen. To back the financial demon up off your finances? To get the cancer out of your body? What is your weapon that you use? Amen. You use the word of God. The word of God is our sword. And when you don't yield the sword, the enemy's going to eat your lunch. When you stand back and murmur about your situation instead of picking up your sword, amen, and using it what it's set out to do and put the devil on flee, put the devil out your house, amen, the spoken word of God will not return void. But when you pick up and say, well, I'm going to call payday loans, or I'm going to go take a Tylenol, or I'm going to go see what my mama got to say about this instead of seeing what the word of God has got to say about that. And you wonder why, amen, you can't get a breakthrough. You wonder why you're still in the same situation that you're in. Because you ain't using the sword. You got to use the weapon that God has given us. It's the word of God. The word of God will accomplish everything it set out to do. It is all powerful. And it will get the job done. Amen. You won't get it done. I can't get it done. Amen. All your money can't get it done. Right. But the word of God will get it done.
Every time.
The word of God will get the job done. My God. The Bible says in Isaiah chapter 55, for as the rain cometh down and the snow from heaven and returneth not hither, but watereth the earth and maketh it bring forth and bud, that it may give seed to the sower and bread to the eater, so shall my word, my God, so shall my word be that goeth forth out of the mouth. It shall not return void, but it shall accomplish that which I please, and it shall prosper in the thing whereto I sent it. That is God speaking through a prophet. And he said, if you speak the word, it'll go forward and do what it set out to do. But you got to speak the word. Amen. We got to come out of that picking the phone up. Amen. Calling our boo, calling our bestie, or whatever you want to call them, and tell them about your problems.
That's right.
We got to get out of that, y'all. We got to pick up the word of God and get on our knees and say, Lord, you said right here, amen, that by your stripes we shall be healed. We got to get back to the word of God. Jeremiah says this. It says, is not my word like as a fire? Come on, we preached about fire a couple weeks ago. Like as a fire, saith the Lord, and like a hammer. The word of God is like a hammer that breaketh rocks into pieces. That's Jeremiah 23 and 29. Think of the word as a hammer. Picture the word of God as a hammer. The hammer can drive home nails.
Yes.
Amen. The hammer, amen, is a positive thing. The hammer can break down obstacles. If I had a hammer, I could tear this whole wall down. That's how powerful the word of God is. It's like a hammer. My God, it overcomes all negativity. My God. The Bible says, this is powerful. Lazarus died. Amen. Lazarus, the friend of Jesus, died. But the Bible says in John chapter 11, that's what it says. But look, he'd been dead for a couple days now. His body was beginning to stink and decay. Amen. Jesus took his time getting to Lazarus because Jesus understood the power that's in the word of God.
Right.
He understood, amen, that when you speak the word by faith, things is going to light up. Things is going to happen. Amen. So when Jesus got to where Lazarus was at, amen, they was crying. Mary and Martha was crying. Jesus shed a tear because they didn't have faith to believe.
Right.
Because they didn't know the power of the word of God. So many times people cry because they don't know the power of the word of God. Instead of crying, amen, you better put your war face on and speak the word of God over your situation. But they were crying because they didn't know the power of the word of God. And Jesus wept because of their unbelief. But the Bible says that when Jesus showed up on the scene, Jesus said unto them, he said, Lazarus, he said, Lazarus, he spoke, Lazarus, come forth. And Lazarus jumped up out of his coffin and been all bound with tape and mummified with all that material. And he came hopping to Jesus. And Jesus said, loose him and let him go. Maybe that's the power of the word of God. Is there anything that God's word cannot do? We got to speak the word, God. We got to speak the logos. Amen. My God, could it be that our light is not as bright as it should be? Could it be that we let the light go out in the temple? Could it be that we have little word because we wrapped up in everything else? Amen. My God, it's time to get the word, to get the source, to get the power back on the inside of us so that the light can shine, so that people that are in darkness can see the light and be saved. The Bible said, the words that I speak unto you, they are spirit and they are life. That's what the Bible says. The words that I speak today, my God, in the Holy Ghost, they are spirit and they are life. If you could just speak the word in your home, if you could just speak the word over your marriage, if you could just speak the word over your mental condition, if you could just speak the word over the pain in your body, the words that I speak, they are spirit and they are life. Thank you, Jesus. And Hebrews tells us that it's quick and it's powerful. The word of God is quick and it's powerful. Amen. It don't take the word long to do what it set out to do. Amen. Amen. The man said, Lord, speak the word and my son will be healed. By the time he got home, his son was healed because the word of God is quick and the word of God is powerful. It's time that we speak the word, y'all. We speak the word of God because it's sharper than any two-edged sword, piercing even to divide and asunder of soul and spirit and of joint and marrow, and is a discerner of the thoughts and intents of the heart. That's the word of God. Look, it's alive, it's living, it's active, and it's alive. The word is not dead. It was wrote in the beginning, was the word. Before earth was ever created, it was the word. Before there was an earth, it was the word of God. In the beginning was the word. My God, it's alive. It's alive. It is spirit and it is life. My God. The Bible says in John 6:63, I read that already. But listen to this right here. Hebrews 4:12. For the word of God is living, it's active. God's words have life. It brings life as did Jesus. Amen. Jesus brought life wherever he went. Amen. The woman with an issue of blood, she was just able to touch him and she got healed. Amen. My God, he raised the dead. He opened the blinded eye. He cast out demons. He cast out swines. Why? Because the word of God is alive. It's alive. What do you think woke you up this morning? It was the word of God. What do you think got you in the house of God? Why are you saved today? Because somebody prayed the word over you. Amen. And the word became alive inside of you. And it drew you. Amen. God will draw nigh to thee as you draw nigh to him. The word of God will draw you closer. Amen. It's time that we speak out God's word to all the Lazaruses that are in our life. Think about it. Devil, come out because you overcome by the blood of the Lamb.
Yes.
Cancer, leave this body because by his stripes we are healed. Finances, get back in line because my God shall supply all of my needs according to his riches and glory. It's time that we speak the word over our situations and watch things begin to line up. They'll begin to line up. Verily I say unto you, if a man keep my sayings, what is his sayings? The word of God. If a man can keep the word of God, if he can just stay in the word of God, the Bible says he shall not see death. Now notice what this says in John 8:51. If a man keep my sayings, and in the sayings, we're talking about the word of God. If we can keep his sayings, ye shall not see death. It didn't say no. Amen. If a man shall know my sayings, he shall not see death. As a lot of people know the word of God, but they're not going to see life. The Bible says, if a man keep my sayings, if he keep it, he shall not see death. So what do you mean? Amen. There's too many false prophets out there that know the word of God, but will not tell the people because they don't want to empty out the church. Amen. Because it's going to change their lifestyle. Let's call it like it is. It's the truth, y'all.
That's right.
Amen. You cannot tell me that you can't see the one God in this. You cannot tell me that you can't see holiness in this. You cannot tell me that you can't see that fornication, adultery, homosexuality, and all other kind of sins will send you to hell. And you're not preaching that. Come on now. We are the watchmen. The Bible says this. If we see something coming and we don't warn the people and they die, their blood is on my hands. That's the word of God. And you got people out there, amen, not keeping the word of God. Look, it's one Lord, one faith, one baptism, one God that's above all, in all, and through all. His name is Jesus. Every knee shall bow, every tongue shall confess that Jesus Christ is Lord. Amen. That's word, y'all. That's word. Everybody, every knee shall bow. But when you don't keep the word of God and you give in to peer pressure, amen. When you give in to your financial situations, then God's got something for you. And you fall right into the category of a false prophet. Somebody that feared man more than they feared God. My God. John chapter 8, verse number 31. It said, and ye shall know the truth, and the truth shall make you free. God's word is true. Let every man be a lie. If you know the truth, you're going to be free. If you know it, you should not have addictions. If you know the truth, you should not have all these mental, suicidal, depression thoughts. If you know the truth, amen, you should not have any type of issues that is coming from the world trying to hinder you from your calling, from your ministry, from your destiny. If you know the truth, you're going to be like David. I am persuaded that neither life nor death, Apostle Paul, neither life nor death, amen, things present, things to come, principalities, nor anything else shall separate me from the love of God. If you know the truth, amen, you're going to be locked up in jail, still working for God. Amen. Paul was locked down in prison, but he was still writing letters to the churches. He was still laboring for the Lord, even while he was locked up in bondage. Why? Because he knew the truth. If you know the truth, you'll be able to get crucified upside down. Right. You'll look at the mark of the beast and say, nah, I'm not taking that. If you know the truth, you'll lose your head for the name of Jesus Christ. That's if you really know the truth. But if you don't know the truth, guess what? You're going to take a chip. You're going to give in to peer pressure. Amen. You're going to find yourself, amen, back to addictions. Like a dog returning to his vomit. You'll go back to the drugs, back to the alcohol, back to the whore lover, because you don't know the truth. The truth shall set you free. My God, when I got truth, amen, I stopped drinking. I stopped whoremongering. I stopped cussing. I stopped smoking. And I start pressing my way to the mark of the high calling in Christ Jesus. And when I fall short, I jump up and say, Lord, forgive me. Knock the dust off and keep pressing. That's what you do when you know the truth. You don't wallow in your sin. You don't stay in one situation long. You get up and you move out. Even though you're wounded, you may be bleeding, you may be hurting, but the work of God still must be performed because you know the truth. You're free to minister. You're free to love. You can go anywhere in the nation and be free. You can talk to any manner of people and won't have any kind of bondage or restrictions because you're free. The truth will set you free. Ain't that the reason why some people still in bondage? Because they ain't got truth. They still can't break that uncontrollable habit that keeps coming up, that keeps pestering them. Amen. Paul had a thorn in his side, but you would never know it. You would never know Paul had a thorn in his side because of all the labor he did for the Lord. Amen. Some of us, we put a thorn in our side. I quit. Lord, I ain't doing nothing till you take it out. It's too much. I can't bear this. The work, the truth will keep you moving forward in God. David said, the word have I hid in my heart that I might not sin against thee. Look, God wants truth. He desires truth in the inward parts. Yeah. Amen. That's what it says in Psalms 51, that God desires truth in the inward parts. What is the truth? The word of God. God wants that word to be in our inward parts, in our heart, in our mind, in our soul. Amen. He wants us to be jam-packed with truth. The word of God, let it bubble out of us. Amen. So much truth. Amen. And when we go to sleep, we quote scriptures. When we wake up, we quote scriptures. You'd be like Johnny James, quote the whole Bible from Genesis to Revelation. Amen. God wants us to be, amen, so filled with truth on the inward parts. Amen. That we don't be affected by the things that's around us. Amen. I got a word for that. Amen. You got so many words for every situation, and you are unaffected because of the word that you have in you. But look, if you don't have any word, you know what happens? You give in to that peer pressure. If you don't have any word, what happens, amen, is you try to find a solution to the problem that's outside the word because you don't have any. Amen. I remember how my mama used to do it. I remember how my daddy used to do it. I remember how my uncle used to do it. Amen. They didn't have any word. Amen. But what they did, they went and got a second job. They went and got a third job. Amen. They went and got this pastor to help them stop smoking. They went and did all these things. But all you got to do is get full of the word. Because if you're full of the word, amen, you're going to be free. You're going to be free. So he hid the word in his heart that he might not sin. First of all, you got to have a desire. Why? Because the antidote for sin is the word of God.
Yep.
The antidote for sin is the word of God. Lord, I love you. But how do you love God? I got into his word and I got to know him. And if you don't get into his word, you don't know him. So if you don't love him and you don't know him, how are you going to not want to sin against him? Amen. Look, I love my wife. I'm not going to do anything that's going to cause an extra gray hair on her head because I love her. I want her life to be as peaceful as possible. I don't want her to have any issues. If I can block all the issues, I'm taking them off.
Yes, Lord.
Amen. Because I want her to just enjoy her life. Amen. And when she's happy, I'm happy.
That's right.
Amen.
Amen.
But now look at this. Look, I'm not going to know it since I know her. I know what she likes. I know what she don't like. I'm not going to do things that's going to bring her heart. I'm not going to do things that's going to make her cry. I'm not going to do things that's going to bring her down low. Amen. Because I love her. It's the same with God. If you love God because you know his word, you know he is the word, and amen, and you love him for who he is, you're not going to sin. You're not going to sin because you love him. And if you do sin, you have an antidote. It's called the word of God. It'll erase all that sin out of your life. Amen. Acts chapter 10, verse 44. Peter was talking to Cornelius' family. And while he was speaking the words of God, the Holy Ghost came on all those who heard the message. The Bible says in verse 46, for they heard him speak in tongues and praise God. So when you speak the word to people that don't know God, that are not filled with the Holy Ghost, guess what happened? The same thing that happened with Cornelius and his household will happen with our loved ones and co-workers if we speak the word of God that pertains to the Holy Ghost. Don't just go in there and speak, oh, Jesus loves you. They know that already. Amen. But do what Paul did. Have you received the Holy Ghost? How have you been baptized? On the John's baptism. Okay. I got a word for you then.
Come on.
And Paul began to preach the word to all of John the Baptist's disciples. And guess what happened? They got baptized in Jesus' name and they were filled with the Holy Ghost. Amen. But we got to speak the word that pertains to that. Amen. We've got to be skillful with the word of God. We cannot look. We are soldiers. We're up front on the battlefield. Amen. You don't have a dull blade. You ain't got a broke blade. Amen. Your weapon is sharper than any two-edged sword. You've got to be able to use that weapon that you have effectively and precisely at the right time so souls can be saved. Look, if someone needs healing, you're not going to talk to them about prosperity. You're going to come to them with scriptures that deal with healing. Amen. If someone needs finances, you're not going to talk to them, praise God, about healing. You're going to come to them about scriptures that pertain to finances. Do you pay tithes? Could it be that you may be cursed? Look what it says in Malachi. It says Jesus owns a cattle on 1,000 hills. All the gold is mine. All the silver is mine, saith the Lord. Amen. But what I'm saying today, and I hope y'all understand this, God is soon to come back. And we've got to have some fruit, y'all. Yeah. The fruit that we had yesterday, it ain't good enough today. That's how serious this is. Every day, we've got to be hungry. We've got to be thirsty for souls. And what's going to get us there, because some of us, we may not be there yet. Let's be honest. Amen. I was, at one time in my life, I was caught up in my problems too. At one time in my life, amen, I may have lost focus too on what really matters. Amen. You cannot chase two hares at the same time, two rabbits at the same time. Amen. You got to focus on one. Amen. So if you're that person today and you're out there and you're struggling with your walk with God and you're hitting and missing, but you got a prayer life and you pray. You come to church faithfully. Amen. You give tithes and offerings faithfully. The thing that you're lacking is the time that you spend in the Word of God. That's what it is. The thing that you're missing is the time that you spend in the Word of God. We know prayer is important. We know fasting is important. Amen. But faith cometh by hearing, and hearing by the Word of God. You've got to have, you cannot neglect the word of God. Hear me, saints of God. You cannot neglect God's word. Because it's the word that's going to get you there. Amen. Come on, we're on the brink of a miracle. Come on, this thing is getting ready to break loose. Could it be that the reason why it hadn't broke loose yet is because we ain't in the word like we need to be? We're on the brink. I'm talking about this thing is so big, everybody coming off their job. It's like Guts got full-time people in the church. We all going to be in the church. We all going to be in the church. That's how big this thing is. Amen. If the income that you got is a lot now, amen, come on. We've got to push. We got to believe God for what he's getting ready to do in our lives. Amen. It's the word of God. It's the word, y'all. Lord, help us, God. Come on, if you're battling the same old spirits, amen, ain't got enough power to blow your nose, amen. Come on, it's the word of God. Look, the Holy Ghost, the Bible said you receive power when you got the Holy Ghost. But look, you got to feed that inner man. You got to feed the Holy Ghost the word of God. And if you ain't feeding the Holy Ghost the word of God, the flesh gonna take over. And when the flesh takes over, guess what? Here comes carnality. Here comes disobedience. No prayer. No reading the Bible. No fasting. Yeah, you had power when you got the Holy Ghost, but you didn't add to it. You didn't feed the inner man. You didn't feed the Holy Ghost. What's the Holy Ghost need? The Word. The Bible says, be not transformed in this world, but be ye. Be not conformed to this world, but be ye transformed by the renewing of your mind. And yes, he will. He'll renew your mind. How are you going to renew your mind? The Word, the Logos. Get a hold of my mind, Lord. Every head bowed, every eye closed. Come on, in the name of Jesus. I don't want to be here that long today. I just want to anoint some folks with oil. Amen. Bring peace to your mind. Bring tranquility to your mind. Bring rest to your mind. Bring back the thirst. Bring back the hunger. Bring back the desire to your mind. Not your heart, your mind. Come on, come on. In the name of Jesus. In the name of you, we plead the blood. We plead the blood. Lord, give her a mind after you, Lord. Give her desire for the word of God. Give her desire for the things of God. God, in the name of Jesus, flow into her mind with the word, God. Let the word of God be a lamp unto her feet and a light unto her path, God. Use this young woman of God. Give her the word, oh God. In the name of Jesus, I pray, Lord. In Jesus' name. Come on, in the name of Jesus. Come on, you here today. Come on, come on. You praying, but you ain't praying like you need to. Amen. You ain't in your word like you need to. Come on. God wants to anoint you today. You'll leave here. Do you believe that today? You'll leave here with a fresh desire for God's word. You'll leave it with a different hunger than you had coming in for the word of God. Come on, in the name of Jesus. You can leave the same way you came if you want to. Amen. My God. Yeah, Lord. Put it all over me, God. Yeah, Lord. Put it all over me, God. In the name of Jesus, God. Put your hand upon my mind, God. God, give me a burning desire for your word, God. Give me a love like never before for the word of God. Use me, God. Let me be a vessel, a chosen vessel, God. Let me, God, lay before you, God. Lord, in the name of Jesus, God. Lord, put it upon me, a fresh anointing, God. A fresh thirst, a fresh hunger, God, for your word. In the name of Jesus, God. Don't let me leave the same way I came, God. It's the word of God. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus, God. I thank you right now. In the name of Jesus. Come on, come on. Come on, is there another today? Is there another today? Hallelujah. Come on, in the name of Jesus. Come on, a deeper walk, a deeper revelation, more knowledge. Increase, 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 increase in this man of God. Increase in him, God. Put it in his mind, God. God, in the name of Jesus, God, I pray right now that you increase in Brother Todd, God. Lord, give him a hunger for your word like never before, God. Lord, I pray in the name of Jesus, God. Lord, God, that he thirst after you, Lord. Pour it out in him, God. Pour it in him, God. Let him be full of your word, God. Let him be full of faith, God. In the name of Jesus, God. Do it in him, God. Do it in his mind in the name of Jesus. Lord, stir up the gift that's in him, God. In the name of Jesus, God. Stir it up, oh God, in Jesus' name. Stir up the gift, oh God, that's within this man. In the name of Jesus, God, I pray. Thy will be done in him, God. No more sitting back. No more not reading. No more not studying. No more not seeking the word for wisdom. In the name of Jesus, God, loose him. In Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. I desire you, Lord. I desire you, Lord. Come on. How many people desire the Lord today? Do you desire the Lord? Hey, come on, Oshata. Do you desire the Lord? Come on, are you hungry? Are you chasing after him? Is he the apple of your eye? Come on, in the name of Jesus. I set my mark on you, Lord, in the name of Yekodoboshata. In the name of Jesus, God. Lord, God, like never before, God. Lord, pour it in, God. Deeper revelation, deeper knowledge, God. Deeper impartation, oh God. In the name of Jesus, his mind, God. Touch his mind, God. Lord, in the name of Jesus. A hunger like never before. For your word, for your truth, God. Lord, open revelation. revelation, God. Open the windows of revelation. Let him see it at a different level, God. In the name of Jesus, God. Do it in his mind, God. Blow it, God, in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. God said a new mind. He give you a new mind, a new mind, a new mind. A mind that's after God's heart. Oh, God. The only thing that will suffice, God, is the word of God. God, let it be a walking Bible in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. God, in the name of Jesus. God, we pray right now the anointing of God upon this apostle, God. The anointing of God. Lord, a hunger, a thirst, a chasing after you, Lord. God, a pursuing spirit, God. She's pursuing after you, God. God, she's pursuing you, Lord. In the name of Jesus, God. Lord, give her the same mindset that the woman with the issue of blood had, God. Lord, she's going to press her way. She's going to press her way, God, to get closer to you, Lord. To get closer to your word, God. In the name of Jesus, God. Oh, yeah, the most out of the most. God, even right now, God, I thank you for the woman of God. And I thank you for what you're doing in her life, God. In the name of Jesus, God. He's on the most shot out of the Moshe. God, in Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. Echo the most shot out. In the name of Jesus. 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 Hey, God, right now. In Jesus' name.